Hey guys, this is All Streamed That, back with another episode of Red Dead Redemption 2. And last time we did a little bit of hunting. We got a couple deer, and then we went out and we attacked a O'Driscoll camp, and on the way back we captured someone and brought them back. And now I think it might be time for interrogation. We're starving him to see if we can make him talk. So let's see what's going to happen.
It's been a bad few weeks. Dutch being Dutch, he is busy making plans. And Dutch being Dutch, those plans involve robbery and dreams.
Who the hell is Leviticus Cornwall?
That's right. Now I see you're introducing into your other passion.
I'll mind you to show me some respect, Mr. Morgan.
Mind away, Rev. You still here then?
Well, yeah.
Then you'll pay me. For the moment, just rest.
Arthur, I think it's time for the train.
You want me to come?
Of course I do, but look out.
I was always ugly, Dutch. Just a scratch.
Don't lie still, son. Blow Abigail.
Jackie. The boy wanted to see you, John.
He's seen me now. What's left of me? What about you?
Guess I was hoping to see a corpse.
Oh.
Bide your time. You'll see plenty of them.
You're a rotten man, John Marston.
He is an idiot, Abigail. We all know it. Now, railway men. Bill, now you ride ahead and set the charge at the water tower just before the tunnel.
Ain't a problem. Why are we doing this? Weather's breaking. We could leave. I thought we was lying low.
Yeah. Come on. What do you want from me, Hosea?
I just don't want any more folks to die, Dutch.
We're living, Hosea. We're living. Look at me. We're living. Even you. But we need money. Everything we have is in Blackwater. You fancy heading back there?
No. Listen, Dutch, I ain't trying to undermine you. I just want to stick to the plan, which was to lie low, then head back out west. Now, suddenly we're about to rob a train.
What choice have we got?
Leviticus Cornwall's no joke, Dutch.
Who is Leviticus Cornwall?
He's a big railway magnate, sugar dealer, oil man.
Well, how good for him. Sounds like he has more than enough to share.
Dutch!
Gentlemen, it is time to make something of ourselves. Get your horses ready. We have a train to rob.
Okay, we're gonna rob a train. That, seems like a good time. There we go.
You worry about yourself, huh?
Enough!
Okay, so we've got the back.
We're gonna need to move fast. Is everyone clear on what they're doing?
Yep, crystal.
Yes, boss.
Good. Now come on.
Okay, so I head straight for the back. As long as I know what I'm doing, I'm fine. If everybody does their jobs, could be a good take. I really like the cinematics in this. There we go.
Feels good, doesn't it? But we need to get this done fast. Now it's falling before anyone gets up here after us. Oh, look at you boys. See? This is what I call a crew. Micah Bell, Charles Smith, Arthur Morgan, Javier Escuela, and what about young Lenny here? Always the first man on his horse.
Just happy we're back at him, Dutch.
You sure you're ready for this, kid?
Of course I'm ready.
Just stay calm. Keep your eyes sharp.
And for the first time, there's really no snow.
No mistakes. Not again.
So we do this, then we go back to Blackwater to collect.
How many times you gonna ask the same question, Micah?
That's a lot of damn money to leave sitting for too long.
It would be crazy to go back there now. The place will be swarming with Pinkertons.
We go back. When I say we go back, and that's the end of it. Money's safe. You'll just have to trust me. And if the O'Driscolls are right, there'll be a stack of railroad bonds on this train. Good money, once we work out how to cash them. Now everyone, shut up and get your mind on the job at hand. Come on. There's the water tower. Hold up here on the ridge.
Okay.
Whoa. Is Bill there?
Yeah.
You want to head down, see how he's getting on?
Okay.
Okay, we want to make sure we don't hit any of those rocks. They will throw us. Okay, there's the detonator. Okay, apparently he's down that way now. There we go. Okay, we've got to pick up the spool, which is here. Okay, and we can't run, we can't do it any quicker. Okay, so we cut the wire,
okay,
put that on.
All right, that should do. You head back up to the others. I've got it from here.
Okay. Well, our hands are no longer clean. We have helped. Okay, he's moving.
Train should be here any minute now.
So we go to the items. There we go. That's a good disguise.
Gentlemen, it's time.
Here comes the train.
You all know what to
do. Yep, I got the rear. Okay. Well, we lost someone. Where? There we go. Got a pole. Okay.
Yeah, you're okay. Now, let's go slow this thing down.
Where's Javier?
He fell. The others will get him.
Let's go.
Come on. We need to stop this train.
There's another guard up ahead. You want me to take him?
Oh, come on. Well, that was not what I wanted to do. Okay. So we're going to try that again. Retry the checkpoint. I know what I meant to do. And it didn't quite go as planned. Okay, come on.
Let's keep moving.
You all right?
Yeah.
Okay.
What the hell was Bill doing? He had long enough to set that charge.
Well, I hooked up the wire, but we won't mention that.
We gotta hurry. We have to stop this train.
That's what we're doing, kid. How you doing there?
I'm okay.
Here we go. Whoop. Oh. Hello.
This train.
There. We got it. Just like that. Oh, we got one right in the head. Okay, I'm good. Wow. Well, I would if you weren't in my way.
Look at this place. It's like a palace.
Now I've seen everything.
Oh, you two got the safe?
I'll search the rest.
Oh, yes. Should be easy as cake. You're just gonna stand there, kid. Pour me some.
There is a letter.
Did all the work.
Yeah, kid did good. Didn't see you rushing to jump on that train.
He's keen.
Dear Mr. Cornwall, we are yet to receive payment of $2,000 for the initial phase of exploration of the Wapati Indian Reservation on Burino, as agreed in the contract between Cornwall Kerosene and Tar and the Leland Oil Development Company dated November 9th, 1898. On receipt of the funds, we will proceed with the phases 2 and 3 of the project and present you with the detailed report of our findings within the month. Yours respectfully, James Critchley, Head of Accounts, Leland Oil Development.
I don't think so. Here, make yourself useful. At least we all know you can read.
Nothing.
Give me those.
Okay.
Railroad contracts, invoices, blah, blah, blah.
We will take the brandy.
Not
Really? Sugar imports from the Spanish West Indies? A lot of sugar? Some fancy new boaties?
We will take the cigar, the pocket watch. Another letter.
Have you checked all the drawers and cabinets?
Letter to Leviticus Cornwall from Archibald Jameson. Thank you for the telegram and your continued interest in the Jameson Mining Company. However, any news you have received of mismanagement or financial difficulties at the mine in Ansburg are simply fake. I would urge you to question your sources. The coal industry is quite different from the oil industry in a number of ways, so I can certainly remain open to a business meeting at your convenience to exchange ideas and educate each other on our respective areas of corporate expertise. I would also be delighted to host you in Ansburg and give you a personal tour of the mine and its associated facilities. I look forward to further correspondence. Yours sincerely, Archibald Jameson. Okay, we always flip. There's nothing there. Let's put that away. More brandy. Okay. Premium cigarettes. Bill Stack. Ooh, that was $25. Okay, let's search the cabinet.
No, this looks like some.
Okay, those were bonds.
Figure got them.
Okay, looks like that's everything we can take. There we go. And we're out.
What did you find?
These
bonds.
They worth anything?
Oh, sure. Bearer bonds. I think we can probably sell these pretty easily.
Well done.
Hey, did you get rid of all of this?
Train? Yeah, get it out of here.
About damn. What do you think?
It's up to you. Kill them, leave them here, take them with you on the train. Just make sure they don't send no folk after us.
Okay.
See you back at camp. When you get back, we'll be moving on. The rest of you, let's ride.
Well. Anybody else? You know what? Dead bodies are better. I am more than okay with dead bodies. Him. All right. Looks like we got another guy right here. And we're going to be looting a few people along the way, I guess. I mean, we can never have too much money, right? Go. Get the train going, and then we just let it roll. We're back at camp.
So, we getting out of this hellhole?
We're gonna try. Weather seems stable.
And we just robbed the Leviticus Cornwall train.
We got money in our pockets. The worst is behind us, gentlemen. So the question is, where now?
I know this country a little. I told you, we should set up camp in Horseshoe Overlook near Valentine. We'll be able to hide out there no problem, as long as we keep our noses clean.
Well, then let's go. Clean noses and everything else. Arthur, you're in that one. Bring Hosea. I know you two like to talk about the good old days and what's gone wrong with old Dutch.
Okay. So apparently we are leaving. Another nice little cinematic. And I will leave you guys with the music.
Surprises. We've had enough of those.
Me? With the boy?
Just go.
Come on, kid. You can buy me a whiskey.
Okay, so we are crossing a river.
Get us out the stream. Gotta keep us moving, but shit. Okay. Let's take a look.
Wow.
We can handle it. All right, Charles, you and me hold the thing up while you try to put the wheel back on, Arthur.
You still strong enough to hold up a leg?
Shut up.
I'm just saying.
Well, say less.
There we go. Okay, I see. You have to do it that way. Well, that's the problem. It's not really attached in any way.
You ain't so useless after all.
Not quite.
Well, it kind of is, I guess. It looks like there's a bolt on there.
bastards. We really screwed them over down here. Come on, let's not push our luck.
What happened?
Well, get in. I'll tell you.
Okay, it must be story time.
Not too far now. Stay on this trail. We'll follow the river, then cut left, inland.
So, yes, the Indians in these parts got sold a very raw deal. This is the heartlands we're going to. Good farming and grazing country, they lost it all. Stole them clean away from them, it was, every blade of grass. Killed or herded up to the reservations in the middle of nowhere.
And how's that different from anywhere else?
Well, maybe it's not. I just heard some of the army out here was particularly unpleasant about it.
Unpleasant? How do you rob and kill people pleasantly? We don't, in spite of Dutch's talk.
I fear I was perhaps trying to simplify something more complicated for the benefit of our blockheaded driver here.
Hey!
Hey, don't blame it on me. Never forget, this here's a con man, Charles, born and bred. Just because it sounds fancy don't mean he knows a damn thing about what he's talking about. So, what happened to your tribe?
I don't even know if I have one. At least, not that I can remember. My father was a colored man. He told me he lived with our people for a while, but a number of free men did. When we were forced to move from our lands, the three of us fled. I was too young to really remember much. All the life I've been on the run.
A couple years later, some soldiers captured my mother. Took her somewhere. We never saw her again. We drifted around. He was a very sad man, and the drink had a mean hold on him. Around 13, I just took off on my own.
That was about the age we found young Arthur here. Maybe a little older. A wilder delinquent you never did see. But he learned fast.
Not as fast as Marsh can, apparently.
Wait, I don't understand. What's the problem between you two?
Arthur?
It's a long story.
Yeah, see, I don't think we ever heard anything about Arthur in Red Dead Redemption 1.
Are we still heading west in search of fortune and repose in virgin forests as we plan? No. Are we heading in the correct direction on our desperate escape from the law eastwards down the mountains? Yes, I believe so.
You know this area?
A little. I've been through a couple of times. There's a livestock town not too far from here called Valentine. Cowboys, outlaws, working girls, our kind of place.
Driscoll's?
Probably them too.
Pinkertons?
Let's hope not.
And this place we're going. Wait, what's it called again?
Horseshoe Overlook.
It's a good place to lie low.
It'll do for now. And how low do you think Dutch is really going to lie?
Probably not very.
Just, you know, maybe it's me who's changed, not him, but... We kept telling him that ferry job didn't feel right. You and me had a real lead in Blackwater that could have worked out.
Maybe.
It just isn't like Dutch to lose his head like that.
Things go wrong sometimes. People die. It's the way it is. Always has been. Me, you, Dutch. We've all been in this line of work a long time. And we're still here, so... I figure we must have got it right a hell of a lot more than we got it wrong.
Okay. And we've got another cinematic. It'll probably take us all the way to Valentine.
Anyway, just some yarrow and ginseng. Good for the health. Better than that stuff you buy in the store. Yeah. You can have all this. I'm at the point where I can do it with my eyes closed.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, so we have some herbs that can be consumed to replenish health. And variety of plants can be found throughout the world. Pick them to learn about their properties. Compendium tracks what you've discovered in the world. It can be accessed in the progress of the section menu. or the pause menu. And we went the wrong way. Okay, so here's the compendium. One animal out of 178 discovered. That is a white-tailed deer. So we also have some equipment. We haven't discovered any fish. One gang. And that is the O'Driscolls. 2 out of 43 plants. There's American ginseng. There we go. And yarrow. So there are... Yeah, so then there's horses, weapons, cigarette cards. So there's quite a bit in the compendium.
There you are, brother. Head in there. Follow the tracks for a bit.
Thanks.
Hey, slow up. I'll jump on.
All right, come on. Okay. Trail's not that clearly marked, but here we are.
You weren't wrong, Jose. This place is perfect.
I hope so.
Gentlemen, we have survived.
But now?
Now it is time to prosper.
Arthur and I were about to prosper in Blackwater. We were onto something big. Then Micah got you all excited about that ferry, and here we are.
We have all made mistakes over the years, Jose. Every last one of us. But I kept us together. Kept us alive. Kept the nooses off our neck.
I guess I'm just worried. I ain't got that long, Dutch. I want folks safe before I go.
Me too.
And now we are stuck. East of the Grizzlies and out of money. A long way from our dream of virgin land in the west.
I know, my brother, but we are safe. We make a bit of money here, then we move again, head out around them, be west of Uncle Sam, in a few months, buy some land.
I hope so.
Would you just look around you? This world has its consolation.
Gentlemen. I'm going to head into the local town and, see if I can strike up a little business.
Of course, Herr Strauss. I prefer robbing banks to usury. Seems more dignified somehow. Now, everyone, put your tools down for a moment. Come on, gather around. Quickly now. I know that things have been tough, but we are safe now, and we are far too... So it is time for everyone to get to work.
Get to work, but stay out of trouble. Remember, we are itinerant workers.
Laid off when they shut down our factory to the north. Now get out there and see what you can find. Uncle, Reverend Swanson, no more passengers. It is time for everyone to earn their keep.
There's a town a little way down the track named Valentine. Livestock town, all mud and morons, if I remember right. That seems a decent place to start.
And, we need food. Real food. That means every day. One of you.
And remember, whatever it is that you find, the camp gets its slice. Now be sensible out there.
Now the girls have your tent ready, Mr. Morgan. Come with me. You two will be ready shortly. We put you over here.
Sure, everything will be fine, Mr. Shaw.
It should be. Most of your stuff from Blackwater got saved.
Everything apart from my money.
Don't talk about me.
Well, we can always make more money.
We're gonna have to. Miss Jackson, I've seen shit with more common sense than you. Do it properly.
Okay. sleep, shave, or change clothes at your tent. And chapter one is over. This is chapter two, Horseshoe Overlook. A couple of weeks later.
Got off the mountain, rode east into some pretty enough country called the Heartlands. We've been this far east in many a year. That seems a little better. His eyes are sparkling once more. I can see he's thinking a little clearer. I think we all feel.
Okay.
Jose.
What a day.
Let's hope so.
There's a bunch of the boys already in Valentine. Bill, Charles, and Javier. And Swanson found something down at the train station by the lake, apparently. And Strauss came back with that creepy little smile on his face. I'm sure there's a whole list of unfortunates he's forced money upon.
Thank you. And you?
I'm gonna read a book.
Okay, so... we should be able to shave, right? Okay, well, let's get into our wardrobe. Okay, no coat. Alright, so I'm going to play around with this for a bit, but I am going to end this episode right here. And you'll see the look that I have chosen at the beginning of the next episode. I want to thank everybody for watching. My name is All Streamed. Hit that like and subscribe button. And ring the bell for notifications.